Hi, I'm Robin Whalley. Welcome to Lenscraft. It seems my previous video explaining how to replace DxO Pure Roll with Photolap created quite a bit of interest. One question that seemed to come up in comments and emails was about the workflow I use to integrate Photolap with Lightroom. So in this video, I'll be explaining how I combine the two. There also seems to be a couple of reoccurring problems, and I'll be explaining how to avoid or fix these. Let's get started with a quick overview of my workflow. The first step is to import new images from my memory card, which I do using Lightroom. This copies the raw files to a storage drive attached to my computer and adds the files to my Lightroom catalogue. After that, I sort, rate and keyword my images using Lightroom. This is important because I don't want to work on every image in DxO PhotoLab, only the best ones. The reason I do this in Lightroom is that I've been managing my photos with it since 2008. I've built up a lot of valuable metadata and adjustments in that time, and I don't want to lose them. After organising my images, I process the best ones using DxO PhotoLab. I do this by exporting them with the Lightroom PhotoLab plugin. The processed image is then exported back from PhotoLab to Lightroom as a DNG file, adding it to my Lightroom catalogue. I can then make any further tweaks in Lightroom before exporting to Photoshop for final editing. Working this way, I can keep my images in Lightroom grouped with any copies. That's the theory, so let's look at it in practice, starting with a RAW file I want to edit in PhotoLab. The way to open the RAW file in PhotoLab from Lightroom is with the PhotoLab plugin. This is a plugin that PhotoLab installs to Lightroom, and it's accessed through the File menu. Here you'll find the plugin Extras submenu, and under this is the Transfer to DxO PhotoLab option. It's important to use the plugin rather than right-clicking on the image. If you right-click on the image to select Edit In or access that command from the menu, Lightroom will process the RAW file. You'll know Lightroom's doing this because you'll see the Lightroom dialog to convert the image to another format. When you use the plugin to send the image to PhotoLab, it presses the original file and avoids processing by Lightroom. If you want to achieve the best image quality in PhotoLab, this is the option to take. Now it's quite possible you won't see the PhotoLab plugin listed in Lightroom. This seems to be a common problem, and I'll be discussing a fix for it shortly. After selecting to transfer the RAW file to the DxO PhotoLab for processing, you should see PhotoLab launch and load the RAW file. A problem I experience at this point is that after launching, PhotoLab doesn't always load the correct RAW file. Instead, it loads the last file I was working on. The easy fix I found for this is to open DxO PhotoLab before using the plugin from Lightroom. If PhotoLab's already open when I send the RAW file to it, it seems to work correctly. Now I can apply my adjustments in PhotoLab, which I've saved as a preset. I can then export the adjusted image back to Lightroom as a DNG file. If you don't see the Export to Lightroom option, click the button to the right and select it from there. After the DNG file is generated and saved, PhotoLab instructs Lightroom to import the new DNG file. It does this using another Lightroom plugin, which I'll show you in a minute. Sometimes it takes Lightroom a minute to pick up and import the new file, whilst at other times it's immediate. If you don't see the file import, just wait for a minute or two. You can even continue to use Lightroom whilst you do this. When the import completes, you'll see a new Lightroom collection added to the DxO PhotoLab collection set. Each export from PhotoLab has its own collection, named with the date and time of the import. Now let's look at the folder containing the original RAW file. This is the same folder I used to save the processed DNG file to, as well as any finished image files. Notice the DNG file and the RAW file are stacked together, which helps in managing them. If you like this automatic stacking of all versions of an image, you can turn it on in the Lightroom preferences. If you look under external editing, you'll see that there's an option for stack with original. When this is selected, any new versions of an image are automatically stacked together with the original by Lightroom. That's the workflow. Now let's look at the problem of the vanishing PhotoLab plugins. I said earlier that you might not see the option to transfer to DxO PhotoLab in your Lightroom menu. I've had this happen to me quite a few times now, and it's usually after a Lightroom upgrade. The way I've fixed it is to first check if the plugin is installed but disabled. You can do this in the plugin manager, which you'll find in the File menu. I can see the DxO PhotoLab plugin in the list and the green ball tells me that it's active. When I click the disable button, the ball turns grey and the option to transfer to PhotoLab is removed from the menu. You'll also see that there are two DxO PhotoLab plugins, although only one of them appears in the menu. The importer option doesn't appear in the menu, but it's used by PhotoLab to import new files back into the Lightroom catalogue. You'll need both plugins to be enabled for the integration with PhotoLab to work properly. Now, there are times when you might not see either of these plugins in the list. If this happens, you need to check your computer drive to see if the plugins are installed. Because I have the plugins installed already, I can click the Show in Finder option. I'll include the plugin location in the YouTube video information, but I only have it for a Mac. Hopefully someone with a Windows version can share the Windows location in the video comments. When you open the location, if you find either of the DxO plugin files there, move them to another directory or delete them. After that, restart Lightroom just to ensure nothing remains in the cache. We then need to reinstall the DxO plugins. Now, these plugins aren't something that you can just download from the internet. They're part of PhotoLab and PhotoLab handles installing them. The way to trigger the installation is to go to PhotoLab and click the Export to Lightroom button. You should then see a pop-up to install the DxO PhotoLab plugin for Lightroom. Click the Continue button and complete the export. At this point, you may still not see the DxO PhotoLab option in the plugin menu, and I found that things don't always work immediately. If you don't see it, restart Lightroom. You should then see a message telling you that the PhotoLab plugin was installed and you should find it in the menu. I hope this video has given you a few new ideas about integrating PhotoLab into a Lightroom workflow. And if you are having any problems with the plugins, hopefully this will help to fix them. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft, I'll see you soon for another video.